Hello, Junior High. Today is Teletubby Tuesday, May 14th. Welcome to this episode of our Daily Video Announcements. I'm Alex.
Hello, Junior High. Grayson here. We're so excited to be here on today's video announcements. Now let's please stand up and honor this amazing country as we say the Pledge of Allegiance together.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you all, and please be seated.
National Day.
Today is the National Buttermilk Biscuit Day.
Biscuits are made using baking powder or baking soda as leavening agent rather than yeast. A typical buttermilk biscuit recipe contains flour, baking powder, baking soda, salt, butter, and buttermilk.
They are often referred to as quick bread, indicating they do not need time to rise. Next up,
robotics. Applications for our next season are open, and if you are interested in participating in FTC, we ask that you please apply at this link below.
Application deadlines are June 1st, 2024 for regular registration and August 31st, 2024 for late registration. Participation involves a cost of $150 per student on time or $180 with late fee to cover the registration fee, tournament fee, t-shirts, and supplies.
Note that there are two sections in the application. Section 1 is for the student to fill out, and Section 2 is for the student to fill out with their parents.
If you are a high school student applying to Juniper Robotics, we will be contacting you early June. If you are a junior high student, we will be contacting you in August.
If you have questions, please feel free to contact Coach Chan or Coach Jarvis.
All the best with finishing up your school year.
Are you looking for a fun, welcoming fall team sport with positive team culture? Join the Sycamore High School Girls Water Polo. Check this flyer and video out.
Next up,
good afternoon, Aviator Nation. Mr. Stern and Mr. Cole here today to do character awards, but we also want to talk about 8th grade day. We are super excited about 8th grade day. It is Monday. I know that this is coming out on Thursday, but one of the things that we want to start talking about are expectations in order to attend 8th grade day, and there are expectations. Before we get to expectations, Mr. Cole, do you have a favorite 8th grade day memory from the past?
Yeah, when I was a student, we played some ultimate frisbee, made probably my most athletic frisbee grab of my life. As a first year teacher, I got pushed in by the lacrosse team into the pool.
Nice.
And so those are my two. How about you?
So when I went to school here, and for those of you who don't know, Mr. Cole and myself, we both are Sycamore Junior High graduates. 8th grade day was throwing us out in the field in the back.
Oh.
And they just said, have fun. That was it. There was no pool.
No pool.
There were no games. Mm-mm. It was just bring a big giant towel or blanket and have fun.
And now, Mr. Tanaka will be running some soccer, right? Mr.
Yeah.
Stinson will be running some tennis. There's the pool, the cookout, so a lot of good time.
Yeah, but I think my favorite memory is probably about 7 or 8 years ago when it snowed in the morning. And we still went to the pool, and they told the students they were not allowed to get into the pool until it hit 48 degrees. So we kind of watched that thermometer, and eventually it hit 48 degrees, and they went swimming. Believe it or not, I don't think that pool is heated.
Nope.
It actually, not like a snowstorm or anything, but definitely flurried that morning. So that was definitely the coldest eighth grade day. All right, so talking about eighth grade day expectations. So students, you are going to start receiving emails from me in regards to behavior expectations. So these emails are going to students who have not met those expectations. So you're going to want to start checking your email, look for the subject that says 8th grade day, and make sure that you are reading that email. And it's not a large population of students. Definitely right now it is less than 10 that will be getting that email. But that email is kind of letting you know, hey, that day might not be a day for you, and it lets you know what your options are on eighth grade day. Of course, attending is not one of the options. So you're going to want to be checking emails, and we're still monitoring. So even though emails will go out this week, does not mean emails will not, again, go out Monday, Tuesday, or Wednesday of next week as well. So we will still monitor PBIS, and if you're in there, you definitely should be looking for emails as well. But we do have a set of emails that are going to go out that are ready to go. So behavior expectations, I think you're going to talk a little bit about academic expectations.
Yeah, and the goal is to get everybody there, right? But again, we're taking the student body, half the student body, over to Blue Ash Rec Center. We want to make sure everybody's safe, everybody's done their responsibility here at school. And so we have a team who are going through our grades for this quarter, and just making sure that we don't have multiple Fs. And so again, you might get contacted for grades. So as you're going through these last couple weeks, I know that it's spring. I know that the weather is warm. People have started the countdown of number of days. But remember that we do have those 12 school days left here on Monday. We need to be doing our academic work. We have some final exams that are going to be coming. So again, same thing. It's behavior. It's academics. We're here to learn. We're here to stay safe. So let's make sure that that you're doing your part. We'll make the PTO, we'll make the day a great time, but we want you there, so let's just take care of your part of it.
Fantastic. With that being said, let's talk about some great students here in our school. These are our Character Award nominations. These are nominations by you. And this one goes to Noah Steenburgen. It says, Noah is a great friend of mine. He was kind to me when I was new to Sycamore. I know we've said that before. When you are new and somebody takes you under their wing, you tend to always remember that person because it's, you know, really special, especially when you're really lost and you're coming into a new place and you don't know the routines and the people, then somebody is willing to step up. You can really be remembered for a long, long time because of that. He makes everyone feel like they belong and is a great friend. Great job, Noah.
And mine is coming from Ms. Huffman's class. It's Shira. And so Shira is the kindest person I know. She is kind to people she knows and ones she doesn't know. She is an amazing listener and so supportive, and she always includes me and others. And this person's just happy they know her. That's pretty cool to get said about. That's pretty neat.
And she's a great athlete as well, as a member of the lacrosse team that only lost one game all
season.
That's
awesome.
So, and congratulations to our boys lacrosse team as well, as they finished third in their bracket at the state tournament. With that being said, we typically go to classrooms on Thursday, Mr. Rodriguez and I, but you can make a difference any day of the week.
Thanks.
Next up, students, make sure your computer is charged for final day of math testing tomorrow. All right. Congratulations, students. Yes, we hit the goal. 91.8% of us students did not receive a referral in April. Yay. We earned a snowy day. Remember to bring your $2 on Thursday, May 16th, to purchase your shaved ice during your lunchtime.
May 23rd is 8th grade day. Celebration at Blue Ash Civic Center for those 8th graders making excellent choices. 7th graders get to hang out at the school. May 30th is the last day of school. Let's continue the countdown. Keep your grades up and turn in your work and finish strong.
Next up.
Who am I here with today?
Julian.
And Micah.
All right, what are you guys' favorite part about the school year?
Oh, it has to be the trip. And SpongeBob.
SpongeBob is goated.
Yeah.
He's the alpha.
All right. So what are you guys scared about for next year?
Life.
Same thing.
Yeah.
Last question.
All right, guys, last questions. Are you going to be doing any sports in your next year?
Oh, yeah, I'm right. I'm going to do a lot.
No idea.
Birthdays. Hope you all have a wonderful day celebrating your birthday. Celebrating today, we have Jen Cat K.
Next up.
And this is Kendall.
And now over to our segment, The Morning Sycamore.
I'm here with Mr. Wolf and I have some questions to ask you about how you like Sycamore Junior High. So here's my first question. How do you enjoy being a teacher at Sycamore?
I really enjoy it. A big part of it is you, Luke, behind the scenes here. Don't know the cameraman all that well, but you guys are the reason why we love showing up every day. I know it's a grind at times, and middle school can be tough, but that's why I really enjoy teaching middle school kids. You guys are in this point in your life where you're all growing. I mean, you have a lot to look forward to. High school on the horizon. It's kind of that bridge from kind of the elementary into the high school. But I love working with all you students, and that's one of the most rewarding things about being a teacher. And Sycamore is a special place. We've got this great new building that's already, we're already feeling like it's becoming a home for all of us. It's a great place to be. It's a great community. But yeah, you kids are the reasons we show up every day, do what we do, and we can't wait to see what you do in the future.
What's your favorite memory about being a teacher here?
Man, favorite memory? Well, this is my fourth year here, so I would say my favorite memory so far, definitely not the COVID year. That was a real struggle, but we got through it. I don't know, I think just probably moving into the new building. I was kind of tough leaving the old building in a weird way because, that had so much history, but probably just being part of a new building, a new atmosphere, kind of a new feeling of community here, that would probably be it.
What made you decide to teach language arts?
I've always had a love for reading and writing ever since I was little. I always loved reading books. I loved to write. I really loved my language arts and English classes growing up, and I thought, as I got older, it might be something to pursue. So it's always been a passion of mine, and then working with kids on those skills has been something that I've really loved. But I also love the feeling that there's so much flexibility with language arts. There's so much choice involved. It's a very different subject area because there is so much room to choose what you want to read and what you want to write. And that's probably the best part of the subject.
If someone asked you, how would you describe Sycamore Junior High?
Oh, family, community. I feel like it is a special place. It's not too big, but it's also not too small. But I feel like there's a kind of a special vibe here where the staff all gets along really well. We consider ourselves a family. The students get along really well. Definitely like family and community come to mind when I think of the junior high.
That's all we have today. Thank you for your time.
Thanks, sir.
Yeah. Well, that's all we have for today. Enjoy your day, make good choices, learn from your mistakes, and go Aves!
Hey guys, I'm with some aviators. I'm going to ask them a few questions. So Santi, what are you looking forward to for freshman year?
Just working on my craft, getting better at what I do, improving as a person overall.
I'm excited to develop more as a person and as a student and athlete.
Get good grades and meet new people.
I'm excited to start my road to Harvard.
Probably the seniors.
Go Aves!
That was good.